All right, looks like we're here already. What is going on, you guys? It is Scotty Witch 97, aka a Mister, and I am back with another live stream. And today we're going to be doing some more Dead by Daylight. Alright, so I might be playing as a survivor this time. I'm probably gonna get some food later on. I have pizza, I'm probably gonna be chicken going in the fridge. But I'll eat once I get the munchies. I might probably take a break from the live stream by the time I get hungry. I don't know, with people like me, it takes a while for me to get hungry again after just eating a while ago. That's why I've been smoking marijuana through cigarette filters. I mean, honestly, most people use cigarette filters to smoke weed. Layout feels different now. My word, why is the theme like so different? Like, did they upgrade something? See if they got any new killers. What's the Wrath character like? Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna start trying out some other ones. I'm gonna try out the Wrath. You know what? I'm gonna read the backstory. Philip O. Jomo came to this country without anything other than hope for a new beginning. He was happy as he got offered a job as Otto Haven Wreckers, a small scrapyard where bribed cops turned a blind eye on the somewhat shady business that took place. Ojomo didn't care. He had seen criminal activity up close in his homeland. And as long as he didn't get involved, he let things be. He just fixed cars and handled the crusher. Something he did really well. A car went in, a small metallic cube came out. It was not until one gloomy day that he just by accident saw some blood coming from one of the uncrushed cars. As he opened the trunk, he found a young man gagged with tied hands and panicked. Phil dies, Ojomo frees the man, who managed to run 10 feet before Ojomo's boss stopped him and slit his throat. As Ojomo demanded answers, he was explained that he'd been nothing more than a simple executioner, as more or less every car had a soul in them. This was a service A scrapeyard provided to certain clients. Ojomo snapped and went ballistic. He threw his boss in the crusher and let it slowly compress. As the head stuck out, Ojomo grabbed it and pulled head and spine out of the body. Then he left and was never seen again. Wow, this killer must be brutal. His power, the wailing bell, a heavy K-siren bell imbued with ancient powers allows its user to enter and walk the spirit world when rung. Wailing bell, press and hold the power button to cloak. Press and hold the power button again while cloaked to uncloak, granting a 1 second burst of speed upon reappearing. The wailing bell can be heard up to a distance of 24 meters. While cloaked, the wraith is granted increased movement speed, near total invisibility, and the undetectable status effect. The wraith may not attack while cloaked, but can interact with environmental objects. Exposure to bright light forces the wraith to automatically uncloak. Predator. Unlocking this perk makes it available in the blood web of all killers. Your acute tracking ability allows you to hone in one disturbance left by running survivors. Scratch marks left by survivors will spawn slightly closer together. Never stop moving and hope you're always 2 steps ahead of the beast. Notebook. May be unlocked in the blood web of the wraith from least from level 30 or in the Shrine of Secrets. Shoot. When I read that. Because the letters are so small. I don't know, the wraith looks pretty spooky as hell. I could play as him. What does the nurse look like? There's the hillbilly. You know what? I'm gonna try out the doctor. A madness including killer who is able to use his power, Carter Spark, to trigger electrical charges, incapacitating survivors and eventually causing them to hallucinate and scream in terror, revealing their position. His personal perks, overwhelming presence, monitor and abuse and overcharge, encourage chases, impact survivors' ability to repair effectively, and make him harder to detect but not in a chase. Alright, let's go with him. Set up his loadout. Alright, what's this one? Monitor and abuse. An uncommon the doctor perk. Meticulous in your approach. Terrifying in your application. While on a chase, your terror radius is increased by 8 meters. Otherwise, your terror radius is decreased by 8 meters. And your field of view is increased by 3 degrees, field of view gains do not stack. I will definitely get that. Overcharge. You are fueled by your hate for progress. Overcharge a generator by performing the damage. Generator action. The next survivor interacting with that generator is faced with a tremendously difficult skill check. Failing the skill check results in additional 3% loss of progress. Succeeding the skill check grants no progress, but it prevents the generator explosion. It is a trap, but a trap one must step in, the doctor. Overwhelming presence. Your presence alone instills great fear. Survivors within your terror radius suffers from inefficiently affected survivors. Item consumption rates are increased by 80%. Shit, I dropped the gaze. One of his favorite quotes, I guess. So all these three perk slots are locked, so I have to get to level 5 for this character. So with the doctor, I'm on level 1. Hey, let's see what level I am with the recent killers I used. There's Leatherface. Alright, he's still at level 1. You know what, they're probably gonna be on level 1 for a while, probably. But I'm gonna go ahead and stick with the doctor. I'm gonna check on his loadout. Good. Dr. Cook. Oh yeah, let's make him even more scary with the suit and stuff. Alright. The stick owned an instrument of punishment when all other treatments failed. Made a punishment when all other punishments failed. Herman Carter strapped in his electric convulsive gear. The doctor is forever forced in a maniacal. How do you pronounce that? Maniacal grin. I think that's how you pronounce it. Wait, I think this takes us to the store. Wait, oh, it's starting, that's why. Okay.
There's an Easter egg on livestock. see some of the Easter eggs. Just the fucking Atlas Store fucking map, just the main area.
Yeah.
Why is it taking so long to load now? Good lord. I'm gonna get some food. I'll be right back, guys. I'm gonna get some food.
See my numbers.
I'm actually gonna put the live stream on pause. BRB, guys. Alrighty, guys, I'm back. I decided to have some food for a bit. I don't want to continue this gameplay on an empty stomach. Alright, now on to the beer. But yeah, once all that gets done installing, I'm gonna see if it'll work this time, and if not, then I'll keep on trying, and I'll keep on trying, and don't give up. Man, my character is spooky as hell now. He's more spookier with the black suit.
Chocolate chips.
But I don't know if I'm going to lie to you about stealing chocolate chips.
But I don't know if I'm going to lie to you about stealing my chocolate chips. Yeah, I know.
Hopefully this match works this time. About time.
I'm not saying somebody Oh,